this week's episode of Aftershock.
Mariana takes us down a trail through history.
Ava bakes some traditional treats.
Ivan searches for the Bay's best actors, and much, much more.
Howdy, Cypress Bay. My name is Mariana Sanin.
And I'm Gabriella Kerber. This special Wild West edition of Aftershock starts now. Baby is that?
This is from our early childhood education class.
I didn't even know Cypress offered that.
Well, here's Gio to tell us more.
At Cypress Bay, there are over 100 different classes. But in the 800s, a new class is growing.
I'm Ms. Castellanos, and I teach early childhood education here at Cypress Bay. This is the first year that the course is being offered at Cypress Bay. The program has actually been around for many, many decades, so I'm very excited to be able to be the first instructor of the early childhood education program.
A new class means new opportunities for students.
So this program is, it's actually a state program through the Department of Children and Family Services. Students have the opportunity to be in the program all 4 years of high school. After the third year, they are eligible to earn their CDA. So they become preschool teachers, and they also will graduate with an honors cord. So within the program, they're learning how to work with children. The program prepares them for early childhood education, but it also helps with anyone who wants a career that has to do with working with children. Or even if you're interested in being a good parent, it prepares you.
These foundational skills are taught in a way a little louder than a book.
And they're learning about the different child development theories. They're learning how to work with kids from birth through age 8. One of the things that we're doing that the students are really finding enjoyable is working with the babies. We have different genders, different nationalities, so they're learning how to properly hold a baby, they're learning how to properly feed, how to diaper, how to change, how to properly take care of a baby. It's going to help nurture and foster their development. It's an amazing program that's going to help you understand a lot of yourself. It's going to help you learn more about yourself, more about the importance of your foundation, of your habits, of what's going on in the classroom. A lot of the behind the scenes of what happens in the classroom, students are not aware of. And a lot of my students are telling me that they're realizing now why teachers have to do things certain ways, and they're building better rapports within the classroom with their teachers and with their peers.
I'm Giovanna Sheldon, CBTV.
October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, a time to give attention to those in need of support.
Samantha found a club that does just that.
With 5,000 students at Cypress Bay, there is a club for almost everyone. But there is one who truly provides hope for those who can't.
My name is Ryan Bieber, and I'm the president of PinkKind. PinkKind's a club is that we raise money towards breast cancer patients who can't afford the resources to go through treatment. And these resources that we hand out are blankets, socks, and any essentials that these breast cancer patients need. This is a club that Cypress was missing. It's because we create a community for those who have had or known or currently know someone that's going through breast cancer, and we're just trying to make a big change out of it and helping these patients. So I sort of just wanted to like say that this whole meaning behind this club is really for my mom. My mom, she's a stage 3 breast cancer survivor.
The statistics weren't so in my favor, truthfully. I had a very rare and very aggressive breast cancer. And with my survivor mission, I'm giving back to help support people that are enduring this really, really difficult diagnosis without the armor to walk into the battle.
And so what she did was all around South Florida, she'd help these patients, giving them the essentials that they need. And I thought that we should branch this out to Cypress. And I feel like my mom really played a role into making me get this idea to get back to those people, so.
With an irreplaceable bond, Ryan's commitment gives confidence and courage to his mother during a time that one could never expect.
It's really amazing because Ryan went through something I'll never know, which is watching his mother with no hair, losing everything, really losing so much. And he persevered. And what's really cool is that this became something he wanted to do on his own.
Ryan hopes to let this ribbon of rose guide his passion further than he could have ever planned.
I hope for the club in the future to make a huge change for those breast cancer patients that can't afford the resources to go through treatment. And I'm just hoping to make a big community out of this.
Pinkkind is humankind, womankind, mankind. It's every kind. And that's the point. So I'm beyond proud.
Ryan will continue to provide kindness to cancer patients in need. And you can too. Visit this QR code to learn more about how you can get involved. I'm Samantha Rosenzweig, CBTV.
Well, well, well. If it's not the one who had beef with Betty's cow.
What?
I know what you did. Don't hide it now.
Why do you care so much about the cow? I was just hungry, that's all.
Well, I'm hungry for a taste of revenge. And there's only one way to settle this.
A barbecue? I can bring Betty if you want.
That's it. Wait. That's it! You're going down! A horse? Should have checked what I brought.
You should have said something earlier.
I wish I was a real cowgirl.
Seriously? Real cowgirls didn't have as much fun as you'd think they have.
What can go wrong riding your horse in the Wild West?
Here's more information on how life was really like in the country.
You may have experienced it through the lens of an old game, but chances are you have no idea what life was really like on the Oregon Trail.
Howdy, Cypress Bay. I'm Mariana Sanin, and I'm here to tell you all about life in the Oregon Trail. Life on the Oregon Trail was a path of death, disease, and danger. Many people packed up their lives to go on this 2,000-mile trip that stretched from Missouri to Oregon for several reasons. People decided to go west for more opportunities, including the Homestead Act that promised people land the size of 121 football fields. It especially made it easier for single, widowed, and divorced women to obtain land in their own name.
So you're thinking, what could go wrong?
Well, a lot could go wrong. Especially if you're traveling thousands of miles without any medicine. So there were many deaths. And I'm not saying a few, I mean thousands. Like, bodies on the trail left behind were modern day speed bumps, like 10 bodies every 1 mile of the trail.
Whoever said nature was the best medicine was a liar. Because having nothing but a flimsy wagon to protect you sure didn't do much for these settlers. If you were an Oregon Trail pioneer, you would have to pack extremely light. The wagons could only carry up to 2,000 pounds, and for 6 months, you would only fit food in there, which only left 200 pounds to fit your whole life in that wagon. The pioneers' mental health began decreasing drastically.
One unpleasant event like this happened to a woman named Elizabeth Markham. She forced her family to leave her at the trail, and when her son went back to get her, she clubbed him until he passed away. If you were lucky enough to survive the 2,000-mile trip while still having your mind intact, then you would make a good road trip ready today. I'm Mariana Sanin, CBTV.
Here's Maya with sports.
What's up, Cypress Bay? I'm Maya Wolf, and we all know the Wild West as the era of cowboys, horses, and dangerous outlaws. But did you know they actually did normal things like play baseball? Here's Sebastian to tell us all about it.
When you think of the Wild West, sports probably aren't the first thing that come to mind, but one sport has stayed popular since way back then.
In 1845, Alexander Joy Cartwright Jr. was one of the organizers of the Knickerbocker Baseball Club in New York, and alongside his associates, he published a set of rules and regulations that became the foundation of modern baseball. But by 1849, Cartwright left Manhattan to join the California Gold Rush, and the story goes that he brought his rules, as well as bats and balls, across the untamed frontier.
Research now says that this may not have been entirely true, but regardless, baseball spread like wildfire across the Wild West.
For the next 20 years, baseball was played regularly in many areas. But it wasn't until 1869 that America's first professional baseball team, the Cincinnati Red Stockings, were formed. They departed west from St. Louis on a rail tour, playing in front of sold-out crowds, inspiring towns from Mississippi to the Pacific to create their own professional and semi-professional teams.
Now you know there's more to entertainment in the Wild West than just tumbleweeds, rodeos, and horseshoe throwing. I'm Sebastian Garcia, CBTV.
Here's Gabriella with the recap of our volleyball team's duel against Western.
On September 18th, Cypress Bay Lightning and the Western Wildcats went head-to-head in a five-set showdown for the books. In the first set, both teams gave their all for a close round, ending with the Wildcats winning 30-28. After a break, the rivaling team showed great skills with strong defense and hits on either side, ending the second set with the Wildcats keeping their lead and winning 25-23. Despite the close calls in the last two sets, Cypress worked together and proved they had what it takes by striking back and winning the third set 25-19. The fourth set of the game was tense, but by setting up powerful kills, the Lightning won 25-19 again, pushing the game to a deciding fifth set. This final set of the game would determine who would win overall. The crowd and benches were on the edges of their seats when finally the clock ran out with the Lightning ahead by 4 points, winning them this set and the game 15-11. I'm Gabriella Kerber, CBTV Sports.
That's all for this week's Lightning Athletics. I'm Maya Wolf, CBTV Sports.
Why'd you put that in your mouth?
What? I'm just trying to get into the spirit.
Ava's trying to get into the spirit as well. Here she is cooking like a cowboy.
Howdy, welcome to the Wild West. Today, I'll be teaching y'all how to make a classic apple pie fit for a cowboy. Let's get started. First, you're gonna need 1 3/4 cups of flour, a cup of ice water, a can of fried apples, 6 ounces of butter, a tablespoon of sugar, and something to mix with. First, you're gonna sieve your flour, sugar, and salt into your bowl. Next, you wanna add your butter and knead it into the flour until it forms breadcrumbs. Next, you're gonna add 6 tablespoons of ice cold water.
Now, fold the water into your mixture to form your dough.
Once your dough is a good consistency, you want to start rolling it out so it's about 1/2 inch thick. Now, I'm just going to take a little bit of leftover butter and use that to butter my pan so nothing sticks. Once you've rolled out your dough, you want to line your pans with the dough. Now, for the fun part, you want to crack open your can of apples and pour them into your pie. Now, you want to add a layer of your pie crust to your pie. And finally, you want to place your pies in the oven at 375 degrees for 15 minutes. Now, back in the Wild West, those cowboys didn't have no ice cream. My tip, get a big old scoop and put it right on top. See y'all next time. I'm Eva Pounder, CBTV.
Howdy y'all. Why are you doing that? What? I'm just practicing my Southern impressions.
Here's Ivan finding some real actors at the bay.
What's up, Cypress Bay? I'm Ivan Rosick, and today we're going to see your acting skills.
What's your name?
Lorenzo.
Rael.
Joao Ludwig.
You have to do a cowboy impression.
A what impression?
So I went to the ranch and I and I whipped some horses, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, yeehaw, I guess.
Yeehaw! I'm on a horse, you know, with my hat on. Yeehaw!
Do your best soccer celebration. Do your best freshman impression.
Freshman?
Oh no.
I don't know how to do that.
Walking.
I'm just walking.
Freshman. Like that.
Yeah, so that's basically our impression.
Well, I'm so excited to be in this new school.
It seems like you guys have to work on your acting skills. I'm Aaron Rosick, CB TV.
That's all for this week's special Wild West edition of Aftershock.
If you want to watch previous episodes, check out our YouTube at Cypress Bay CB TV and follow us on all of our social medias. I'm Mariana Sanin.
And I'm Gabriella Kerber. Thanks for watching.